Hi all, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I am going to discuss about regular expressions. So, the language accepted by the finite automata can be represented as a regular expression. That means regular expression is nothing but the expression of the language. What the language says, that can be represented with the help of a regular expression. Let's look into some rules about the regular expressions. So, coming to the first rule, any terminal symbol belongs to sigma. Any terminal, any input symbol, any terminal symbol belongs to sigma and phi and epsilon is a regular expression. So, any input symbol which belongs to sigma is a regular expression, phi is a regular expression and also epsilon is also a regular expression. So, I can say that if sigma is formed or the input symbols a comma b, if sigma is formed or the input symbols a comma c, a comma b, I can say that a is a regular expression. B is a regular expression. If suppose the input the sigma consisting of input symbols 0, 1, I can say that 0 is a regular expression, 1 is a regular expression like that. Along with that, we can also say that phi is a regular expression and sigma epsilon is also a regular expression. And coming to the second rule, if R is a regular expression, then closure of it is also a regular expression. Closure is represented with R star. So if R is a regular expression, then its closure is also a regular expression. For example, if I say that 1 is a regular expression, for example, if 1 is the regular expression, according to the rule 2, I can say that its closure in the sense 1 star is also a regular expression. 1 star in the sense, what are the elements in 1 star? 1 star means we can have 5, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 and so on. These are all the strings in closure of 1. So, if R is a regular expression, then R star is also a regular expression. And next, coming to rule 3, if R1 and R2 are regular expressions, so here R1 is a regular expression and R2 is a regular expression. If so, then their union R1 plus R2 is also a regular expression and their concatenation R1 dot R2 is also a regular expression. So, if there are two regular expressions, R1, R2, then their union is also a regular expression and their concatenation is also a regular expression. So, for example, if A is a regular expression and B is a regular expression, then I can say that A plus B is a regular expression and AB is a regular expression, union and concatenation. And point to be noted is that an expression obtained by all the above rules, finite number of times, is also a regular expression. So, based on these rules and based on this basic information, let us analyze whether the given expression is a regular expression or not. So, we have two examples in our hand. Let me go through one by one. So, here the first example is 0 star 1 star. So, now we need to find out whether this is a regular expression or not. So, here let us consider here this is the expression where the input or the terminal symbol epsilon sigma is equal to 0 comma 1. So, here I can say that 0 is a regular expression. 0 is a regular expression and also here 1 is a regular expression. Since 0 is a regular expression, why? Because from rule 1, any terminal symbol belongs to sigma is a regular expression. So, I can say that 0 is a regular expression and 1 is a regular expression. And from rule 2, if R is a regular expression, then its closure is also a regular expression. So, from rule 2, I can say that 0 star is a regular expression because 0 star is closure of 0, right? And 1 star is a regular expression. So, these two are from rule 2 and these two are from rule 1. So, till now, I know that the 0 star is a regular expression and 1 star is a regular expression. And I can say that 0 star, 1 star is a regular expression from rule 3. So, what is rule 3? If R1, R2 are two regular expressions, then their concatenation is also a regular expression. So, here 0 star is a regular expression, 1 star is a regular expression, then their concatenation. So, concatenation is nothing but 0 star, 1 star. So, this is also a regular expression. So, in this way, we can prove that this particular expression is a regular expression. So, consider the second example. Here, you have sigma epsilon plus 1 plus 1 1 plus 1 1 1. So now we need to check whether this is a regular expression or not. Okay, from rule 1, I can say that epsilon is a regular expression. Why? Because in rule 1, we wrote here that epsilon is a regular expression. And also from rule 1, I can say that 1 is a regular expression. So these two I can write from rule 1. Epsilon is a regular expression and 1 is a regular expression because 1 belongs to sigma. 1 belongs to sigma. So these two are regular expressions. And I can also say that 1, 1 is also a regular expression. Why 1, 1 is a regular expression? Why? Because here 1 is a regular expression and another 1 is also a regular expression. And from rule 3, concatenation of two regular expressions is also a regular expression. So this is from rule 3. And similarly, I can say that 1, 1, 1 is also a regular expression. Because 1 is a regular expression, 1, 1 is also a regular expression. So here we wrote that 1 is a regular expression. And here we proved that 1, 1 is a regular expression. So from rule 3, here also from rule 3, concatenation of two regular expressions is also a regular expression. And again, I can also say that epsilon plus 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1, 1, 1 is also a regular expression from rule 3 only. Why? Because here epsilon is a regular expression. We proved that epsilon is a regular expression, 1 is a regular expression, and next 1, 1 is also a regular expression, and 1, 1 is also a regular expression. So union of two regular expressions is again a regular expression. So from based on that rule, from rule 3, we can say that union of all these is a regular expression. So in this way, we can identify whether the expression is regular expression or not. Coming to regular set. So regular set is nothing but any set represented by the regular expression is nothing but a regular set. Consider an example. Here is a regular expression. So what is a regular set here? Set in the sense set of strings. That means a set of all the strings defined by the regular expression can be a regular set. So here the only string defined by this regular expression is 1. So this is the regular set. And here also we can have either 0 or 1. So the strings defined by this regular expression is either 0 or 1. That is a regular set. And here there is only one string that is 0, 1, which is expressed with the help of a regular expression. So here for the third example, the only string obtained from this regular expression is 0, 1. So this is only the one in the set. So coming to the 1 star. So here 1 star is a regular expression. Then what are all the strings coming under 1 star? So we can have epsilon, we can have 1, we can have 1, 1, we can have 3 ones and so on. So all these strings belonging to a regular set. Coming to this particular regular expression, here it says that this regular expression should consisting of the strings AB or B or AA. So here we can form set like this, it consisting of AB or it may also consisting of B, it also consisting of AA. So in this way we can form regular sets from the given regular expression. Thank you for watching the video.